35 seconds. We're just a few seconds away from switching to the redundant send sequencer. T-minus 27 seconds. We have gone for redundant send sequencer start. T-minus 20 seconds and counting. T-minus 15, 14, 13, T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 1, remain engine start.
Perfectly suspended in the center of the universe. The ultimate creation from an infinite mind. An unbelievably intricate, complex design. A supernatural testimony and an irrefutable sign that there is a God. The size, position, and angle of the Earth is a scientific phenomenon to see. A few degrees closer to the sun, we'd disintegrate. A few degrees further, we'd freeze. The axis of the Earth is tilted at a perfect 23-degree angle. It's no mistake that it is. This allows equal global distribution to the rays of the sun, making it possible for the food chain to exist. Or take, for example, the combination of nitrogen and oxygen in the atmosphere we breathe every day. It just happens to be the exact mix that life needs to prosper. It doesn't happen on any other planet that way. You see, the Bible says the invisible things of God are clearly seen through His creation. To believe this is not hard. If there's a design, there's a designer. If there's a plan, there's a planner. And if there's a miracle, there is a God. There is a hope. There is a light. There is an answer to all answers.
There is a flame that burns in the night. And I know there is a God.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the skies proclaim the work of His hands. If we allow our minds to drink in all the truth that just surrounds us, creation itself will help us understand. Did you know the moon controls the tides? It's the maid that cleans the oceans. Even the waves don't crash the shores in vain. The tides drag impurities into the depths of the sea. It's nature's constant recycling chain. It simply boggles the mind to think that the stars will rotate with such exact precision that it's true that the atomic clock with an error factor of less than 3 seconds per millennium is set by the way they move. Though they silently orbit, the sun, the moon, the stars are like celestial evangelists above who circle the earth every 24 hours shouting in every language that there is a God. The wedge under the foundation of our faith, trying to topple our relationship with Christ. When the fool said in his heart there is no God, he rejects the truth God painted on the canvas of the night. Atheism has never created an artistic masterpiece, never healed a fatal disease or calmed a fear. Atheism has never still given answers to our existence, peace to a troubled mind, or even dried a tear. For it's God who created heaven and earth and flung the stars in space and breathed in a handful of dirt and became a man. It's God who sits on the circle of the earth and measures the mountains in a scale and holds the seven seas in the palm of His hand. It's God who sent His only begotten Son to the cross of Calvary to save our souls from hell and the grave. It's God who creates, God who delivers, God who heals,